Rolling record.
Bring up bars and tone.
10, 9, 8, 7.
Ready to fade
six,
to black.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Fade to black.
One. 10, 9.
Ready to fade
eight,
and slate.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fade and slate.
10, 9, 8, 7.
Ready to fade
six,
and opening graphic
five,
and music.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Fade and opening graphic and music.
Ten, 9. Eight,
or actually, no,
seven,
fade to black.
6, 5, 4, 3,
ready to fade
and
open graphic
two,
music, fade and open graphic music.
10, 9,
ready to
eight,
dissolve to music,
seven,
fade and host
six,
mic, dissolve
five,
to cam 2, ready
four,
to cue talent.
3, 2.
Back to Sports for Breakfast, where we talk about weekly sports news. Go on and grab yourself some cereal. We have a great show for you. Let's get right into it with Lonzo Ball and his most recent injury.
Yeah, Edwin, Lonzo finally made his much-anticipated return after 2 years of recovering from a knee injury. However, after only 3 games, Lonzo has sprained his wrist and he's now out for another 10 days.
Calvin, with this setback, how do you think this is going to affect his reputation?
Well, unfortunately, Lonzo's reputation has been that he's an injured player, and this is going to hurt the Bulls going forward. Lonzo averaged 4.7 points per game and 3.7 assists per game in his 3-game return. Unfortunately, this will hurt Ball's reputation of breaking back into the starting lineup soon, as the Bulls are stacked at the point guard position with Ayo Dosunmu and Kobe White.
Calvin, one of the Bulls' biggest offensive acquisitions was adding former OKC Thunder guard Josh Giddey to the lineup.
Yeah, and so far the Aussie, Josh Giddey, fits right at home with the Bulls. He's been averaging near double-double numbers to open up the season. Giddey is averaging 14.7 points per game, 7.1 rebounds per game, and 6.3 assists per game. I really like this move for the Bulls to start off the year, and it's going to give them some offensive firepower.
Well, in other sporting news, Ice Cube kicked off the World Series with a stunning performance.
Yeah, and Edwin, I have to say it was a good day for the Dodgers. Ice Cube also performed at the Dodgers World Series Championship Parade, capping off a truly incredible season for the Dodgers after they dominated the Yankees in the World Series.
Well, now on to football, for the Bears have shocked the NFL world with a stunning loss to the Commanders this past weekend, losing 15-18.
Edwin, this loss absolutely killed me for the Bears. The worst part about this game is that the Bears had a late lead 15-12 when Jaden Daniels launched this 58-yard touchdown pass with 2 seconds remaining to steal the win from the Bears. Truly a horrible way to lose a football game.
And the Bears are going to play back at home on November the 10th, facing off against the New England Patriots. How do you think this is going to turn out, Calvin?
Well, we have an interesting game here between two rookie quarterbacks looking to prove themselves to start the year. On one end, we have Caleb Williams with the Bears, and on the other, we have Drake May with the Patriots. The Bears are going to have to apply some pressure on the rookie quarterback if they want to gain an edge in this game. Edwin, I think it's going to come down to the defenses here. The Bears are probably going to have to get at least one or two turnovers and limit their own turnovers if they want to win this game.
Well, we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, it's all about UFC. Welcome back to Sports for Breakfast. In case you missed it Saturday night, here's Calvin with the scoop on UFC Fight Night.
Edwin, we had a great night of fights on Saturday. The main event was the assassin baby Brandon Moreno against the prince Amir Albazi in Edmonton, Canada. The fight went the distance and ended in a unanimous decision
for
Moreno.
Camera one.
The baby assassin, Brandon Moreno, looked back in championship form as he dominated Albazi.
Take OTS.
Moreno threw 132 significant strikes compared to Albazi's 63. Really an impressive performance.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now tell me, Calvin, if there's any other big UFC news our viewers should be informed about before they have some early morning coffee.
Yeah, Edwin, some MMA fans are calling this the knockout of the year by Ilya Topuria against Max Holloway at UFC 308. Topuria delivered a devastating left hook in the third round to knock out the current BMF title holder, Max Holloway, for the first time in his career. Really tough loss for Max Holloway, but I do think he'll bounce back.
Great.
Okay, we're going to stretch it. Please. So, camp two, ready.
In other news, the Bulls, as we talked about, are without Lonzo Ball, so that will hurt them going forward.
Mm-hmm.
They were unable to beat the Cleveland Cavaliers the other night, who are undefeated on the season to start off the year.
We can also
pretty
take
impressive
ready
by the Cavaliers.
Mm-hmm.
The Bulls are really shooting the ball well right now. They're great at three-point shooting, but the problem is they can't seem to stop anybody. I don't think they could even stop a cold at this point.
Mm-hmm.
If the Bulls really want to have some more success this season, they need to keep passing the ball around, make their three-point shots, and play a little bit better defense.
Take two.
You're not going to be able to beat anybody when you're giving up 120-plus points a game. It's just not going
to
work.
45.
Great.
Okay. So if you can talk for 15 more seconds, I'm going to go to the close.
And some other
point.
Yeah, some other news. Stephen Curry's been dealing with a shoulder injury to start the year. Luka Doncic on the Mavericks has been dealing with a bit of an ankle injury.
Okay, wrap him up, please.
Because of that, NBA fans are going to be wishing that they had their superstars back soon.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's all the time we have.
Great. Well, that's all the time we have here at Sports for Breakfast.
Full screen close.
We also like to give a big thank you to Calvin for spending some time with us today. And for everyone here at Sports for Breakfast, thank you for your tuning in today. Next week, we'll probably be discussing another Bears loss. And thank you. Have a great day, everyone.
Okay, ready,
except
fade out mics.
Ever flute.
Fade out mics, fading graphic. Fading music.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And fade out music, fade out graphic, or actually music can stay in. Fading credits.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
Ready to fade out music and fade out. Post. Yeah. Okay. Stop tape.